of started this business because we really felt strongly that there was a better way to do food production. And that sounds really cliche and it's really broad, but realistically speaking, we view what we do as being like one small step towards really changing how food is grown and how it's distributed. So, and giving, honestly, people more opportunities to consume it. So for us, you know, like, I kind of see the future being one where people are like really well connected with their food, really well connected with the person that grew it. And eventually, I see the consumer as being the person that actually grows their food. So as we work on this technology, as we improve it, it'll get to the point where I don't expect to see ugly brick buildings anywhere. I expect to see buildings covered in food, buildings covered in beautiful produce. I mean, I think plants are some of the most beautiful things on the planet. And why would we want to look at brick when we could look at plants? And more importantly, why would we want
to
look at...
You know, you're talking to an architect.
Right.
Just an FYI.
Well...
I like brick.
This is,
but I actually do like brick covered plants.
But this plays a role in that. I mean, we're never going to get rid of brick.
No,
but.
In fact, it's interesting how the brick works with it. The way you were saying that you have this fabulous thing here. We have all this hard surface and this nice south face, and you're getting an extended growing season.
Yeah.
You know, if this was mounted in the middle of a field on a chain link fence,
it
wouldn't help as much. You'd have winds. You'd have all these other issues. So brick and plants working together.
Yeah, it's uniquely suited. I mean, it's playing off of an advantage that existed that no one really knew about or understood until we started placing plants there.
Yeah.
And, you know, I see it working together. I mean, the amount of research on how it impacts heating and cooling costs for buildings, and I mean, there's just so many benefits that, living walls can offer to buildings and to architects. I mean, it's an entire new palette to play
it's
with.
Pretty wonderful. Yeah. So, now, what happens to this in the wintertime?
In the wintertime, you know, these things pop right off the wall. So, can't really show it to you. But, I mean, you see how easily the towers pop out?
Right.
So, I'm going to smash that one if I take it out. But, you know, these towers just pop right out. Right. So, these come off, and then the gutters just...
can stay there.
You can leave them there if you want, but they pop off the wall, too.
Okay.
So it's all mounted with really simple, with a very simple stainless steel bracket system.
Right.
And so during the winter, it can all be removed and it just goes back to being a brick wall. Or, you know, some folks will plant like rye or barley or grasses and they'll leave them up all winter long.